Well, indeed, good afternoon. Welcome to this belated edition of KTN Business. Today, my name is Peter Akaba, and over the next 1 hour or so, we will endeavor to bring you up to speed on news making headlines in business here in Kenya, here in Nairobi, across the region, and indeed right across the world. Of course, the biggest story right now being that bilateral conversation between the Kenyan President Uhuru Kenyatta and the Somali President Mohamed Abdul Farmajo, who is in Nairobi, well, to pick up the conversation around, of course, security, the incentives for Somalis to start traveling back to their countries, and of course, a whole host of other issues, which include immigration, things like the visa processes and trade barriers and tariffs between the two countries. Also on this show, the fact that, well, Tecno, one of the world's largest phone makers, has launched the Come On CX here in Nairobi. Two versions of that phone now available right across Africa starting tomorrow. Do, of course, look out for that conversation online, because we have been covering that in a very big way on our Twitter handles, on Facebook, and, of course, on other platforms like Instagram. As usual, we start off with a Twitter poll question, and today we are asking, what incentives do you think Kenya needs to undertake to fully embrace entrepreneurship? Again, what incentives do you think Kenya needs to undertake to fully embrace entrepreneurship? Now, the reason we're asking that question is because our conversation here today has a huge bent towards, of course, entrepreneurship in the second part of the show. Do reach out to us. The hashtag is Business Today. You can, of course, talk to me directly on at Peter Akaba, or reach out to us on the hashtag, on the handle at KTN News. We will sample that conversation as the show does go on. Well, indeed, we start off with some nostalgic and good news, where Iveco, that is the Industrial Vehicles Corporation, an Italian industrial vehicle manufacturing company, has officially announced its re-entry back into Kenya at the industrial and commercial operations level here in the Kenyan market through a partnership with Global Motors Center. The company is currently setting up its assembly plant in Mombasa. GMC will be responsible for the assembly and distribution of the brand's full product range in the region, which will include Daily, Eurocargo, and the Tracker. Iveco is CNH Industrial Brand, a global manufacturer of light, medium, and heavy commercial vehicles, city and intercity buses and coaches, firefighting vehicles, defense vehicles, and off-road vehicles for construction and mining work. It is targeting the Kenyan market, which is becoming increasingly strategic to the commercial vehicles business globally. This move will further consolidate Iveco's leading position in the region.
Jump till 1,000 units in 5 years. So that is the plan, as mentioned also by the GMC managing director, and according to a plan to have till 600 workers in the plants. But the production capacity in terms of tools is still there, so it's just a matter to improve the sales and to, of course, to hire new people starting from the previous 50 people that will start very soon to assembly and to work in our new plant in Mombasa.
We have signed an agreement with Iveco to do the assembling of Iveco units, Iveco vehicles here in Kenya. We will be assembling it at our assembly plant in Mombasa, which has, made us invest about 2.3 billion.